Okay, so we will start it again and in the previous again. So from the today we will start about the groundwater storage and the flow. So what is the groundwater storage? The groundwater storage is a type of storage where the water is stored under the ground. So as you know that we have tube wells. So from tube wells, from where we get the water from the deep tube wells like that, we get the water from under the ground. So as you can understand that there is a large amount of the water is stored under the ground. So this thing is also known as the water table. In sometimes it is also known as the water aquifer, although this is not, it does not show the full scale thing what is actually understood by the ground water storage. In the future when we will learn more about the hydrology, we will actually learn about the groundwater storage more. So what really happens that in the case of the water, as it is saved inside the water, this huge amount of water, now this soil is full of multiple pores, which you have already learned in the soil mechanics, that soil is not only solid but it has also some pores which is filled with gas and other and fluid. So what happens that the fluid moves through these pores and makes sometimes they went through the surface of the water. So this thing of the flow happening through this way is known as the groundwater flow. So in the case of sometimes we will see that although it is raining low, or sometimes due to the dam the water storage in the dam is very high, sometimes you will see that in the river there is no shortage of water, or there are some amount of water always flowing through the river. So this thing is actually known as this thing actually happens due to this groundwater storage and flow. You cannot see these things in open because this thing is totally happens under the ground. But in the case of sometimes when there is a little bit less water in the river, and it is opened in some places, any place, then you can easily see how the waters are coming through different through the soil to the ground. In the case of Damodar you can see there are some points where there are this type of water is actually flowing. Then this groundwater not only flows through these horizontal waves, it sometimes actually flows in the vertical way also. So how this groundwater is created? So you know that there are precipitation occurs on the ground surface, and from there the infiltration occurs. Okay, so what is infiltration? We will learn in the latter part of the slide. So we have to know that the infiltration occurs, and this infiltrated water when goes down, and if there is no porous way, or there is no pore or no seepage waves going towards the downward, then this water is stored there. Thus it forms the groundwater storage, and if there is seepage going on through the surface, then it flows just like the surface flow, which is known as the groundwater flow. Okay, so this is all about the groundwater storage is like, and then comes the spring. Okay, so what really happens in the spring? As you can see in the picture that you see that this is a surface and these are the aquifers. Okay, here it is seen a large amount of the aquifer. Sometimes this huge amount of aquifer does not there, sometimes a single aquifer is also there. So what happens, this aquifer actually intersects the surfaces, and what happens that this extra water comes out of the aquifer and they come as the spring, such that as you can see in the picture, that through this surface, this water has been coming out of the mountain. You can see that in this case, what really happened that there is a sub aquifer inside this mountainous surface, and this aquifer is actually got intersected with the mountainous terrain, and this extra water is actually coming out of the mountain, which is shown practically here. So You can see in here also that it is a concentrated discharge of the groundwater flow when it comes to the ground surface. The spring of the water source is, the spring is water source formed when the side of a hill, a valley bottom or other excavation intersects the flowing body below the local water table. As I have shown you earlier, that the aquifer is actually gets intersected with the hill section. So the spring is the result of the aquifer being filled that the water overflows into the land surface. So I hope that you understand the spring part. Okay, next is evaporation. You have learned this thing from your early days of the school. So what is evaporation? Evaporation, we have known that it is the removal of the water molecules or other liquid molecules from the water surface to becoming gas or vapor. Okay, gas or vapor. The evaporation is the main pathway or the primary pathway, such that the water moves from the liquid state back into water cycle. Although there are other ways also, which we will learn later, but this is the main evaporation way. And we have learned in the earlier slide that as the ocean actually takes a huge amount of the surface, so they actually contribute the 90% of the moisture in our atmosphere, combining ocean sea lakes, and 10% is being contributed by the plant transmission, which is evapotranspiration, which we will learn later. So you know the heat is necessary for the evaporation to occur. So when only occurs when the rate of evaporation exceeds the rate of the condensation. So what is the condensation? We will learn that just after the next slide after this. So as you can see in the figure that this is the liquid, and when the heat is applied, then this liquid becomes gaseous particles and they become the gaseous vapors. So this is what happens in the case of evaporation. Then we come to the evapotranspiration. This term is new. Although we have in the case of biology, maybe you know in the case in some of these terminologies, but in the case of hydrology or the common science case, and this is a very new terminology, it is the evapotranspiration for you people. So what is evapotranspiration occurs? That the root of a tree actually takes water from the ground for its living. Then what happens that this excess water goes to the leaf and helps in photosynthesis, and this excess water is then gets out of the tree surface to the bottom part of the leaf. So this thing is known as the evapotranspiration, as this is a part of the transpiration also. So it is seen as in the earlier slide we have told that the 10% of the moisture found in the atmosphere to the evapotranspiration. And in the case of, there are multiple factors which is affected by the evapotranspiration, which is temperature, relative humidity, wind and other air movement, soil moisture availability, etc. In the case of biology, if you don't know that, then we will learn them in the case of evapotranspiration in the latter part of this subject. Next is sublimation. Sublimation is what? Sublimation is the turning of the solid particle into the gaseous particle directly. Okay, so what happened in the case of dry ice. So as you can see in this figure, above the mountain there is a mixture of the cold layer or fog. So this fog is not the water vapor. This thing is actually the frozen carbon dioxide, which is also known as the dry ice. So in the detail, if you see that, you will see this thing. This is another example of the dry ice. Okay, so now this thing is known as the sublimation. Next is water storage in atmosphere. So what is really happened that what basically what we know them as the cloud. So although this amount is very less, only 0.001% of the earth water, but this is an important thing for the transportation of the water from one place to another. As we can see, while having the rain or the while having any storm, the weather forecasting system says that the low pressure point is created at one point and the rain occurs in the another point after making becoming a strong wind. So strong wind or strong cloud system. So this in this case the cloud takes an important role, or atmosphere takes an important role to the transformation of the cloud from one place to another and make the precipitation to the other place. Okay, although in this case the cloud is the most visible case, as you can see also in the written, it is right there, the cloud is the most visible case, and here the water particles are too small to be seen. Next is condensation. So what is condensation? Condensation, if you use a glass of water and put some ice inside the water, what you will see that there are some water particles is formed outside of the bottle or the glass. So what is this? This water is known as, what happens that when the vapors outside the glass it become very cooler, then it loses its latent heat and it becomes the water molecules. So in an easier way, what we can see that when the gaseous formation becomes liquid, it goes through the process of the condensation, but when the liquid system goes gas, so it goes through the process of the evaporation. So therefore it is written that the condensation is the opposite of the evaporation. So it is responsible for ground level fog, as you can see the picture, the glasses fogging up in the somebody from to go home from the cold room to the outdoors, such that when you sit in the AC room, you can see and put the AC in a lower temperature, you can see that there are a lot of other water particles from outside the glasses of your window or doors. Okay, so in this case this is what we know as the condensation. Then we go for the precipitation. This thing is all you also know this thing from in your early classes, but here not only in the case of we will know about the more detail of the type of the snow at their calculation in the upcoming classes. So in the what happened that when the water particles is mixed up with the dust or smoke particles, they actually form a nucleus. This nucleus is not a very big particle, but after colliding with multiple nucleus they become very very large particle, and these large particles are attracted towards the gravity and they form the rain particle. Now they not only in the case of rain, but it also falls in the form of the snow, sleet or hail. Okay, what these things actually tell, we can tell you that later. Okay, in the upcoming syllabus. Finally, it comes to the infiltration. What is infiltration? So infiltration is the process when the rain falls on the ground, what happens that the ground has a lot of water pores, as we have learned that in the groundwater system. This water actually moves through the ground using these pores, and what happens that what the actual amount of the rain actually falls, that amount of the rain does not gets out, which we have learned as the norm of the runoff. This type of thing is actually known as the infiltration. Okay, so it is also a type of the flow of water inside the ground. So this thing gradually moves throughout the vertically or horizontally, and this infiltration takes a big role in the formation of the groundwater. So this is all about this hydrologic cycle. I hope you understand, and thank you very much.